Blue Note 4146. Our man in Paris, Dexter Gordon. So this is part of the Blue Note 4000 series, and I've loved being a part of it. This one in particular, Dexter Gordon, Our Man in Paris from 1963 with Bud Powell, Pierre Michelot, and Kenny Clark. Okay. Great tenor sax player. Now, tall man. I'm wearing a pork pie hat because he's one of the jazz artists like Lester Young that always wore a pork pie hat. So I changed brims, hats, in honor of doing this record. I was fortunate enough to see Dexter Gordon two or three times in the 1970s at the Keystone Corner, the famous jazz club in San Francisco, North Beach, San Francisco. Now, in between songs or sets or different parts when the audience applauses, Dexter would show his love to the audience maybe, but also his love for his instrument. And he would take, this is not a saxophone by the way, this is an Epiphone Casino guitar. Anyway, Dexter Gordon would hold out his saxophone across his hands like this, as if presenting it to the audience or honoring the instrument that he just performed an amazing tune with. I think he's like 6'6", tall man, just an amazing musician, amazing saxophone player. Now, in 1959, during the 50s, you know, a lot of jazz musicians were moving to Europe, so expatriates, because of the jazz scene was so much more healthier there than in the States. I mean, New York had jazz scenes, San Francisco, Kansas City, Chicago, spots here and there, but it was Europe where they really revered our jazz artists, these American jazz artists. So 1959, at 40 years old, Dexter Gordon moves to Copenhagen, but is in Paris for a while, and does this session for Blue Note Records. At the last minute, Bud Powell joins this session. I think they were gonna be, forgot who it was, another pianist was originally scheduled and was replaced by Bud Powell, who comes out of the bebop era. Now, I really can't talk about just Dexter Gordon when discussing this record, because Bud Powell, one of the most amazing original jazz pianists, comes out of the bebop era, which I'm a huge fan of. Dexter definitely crosses over that era as well when he was younger. So Bud Powell comes in. Originally, there were going to be some originals on this record, but I don't know if he was lazy or what, but Bud Powell didn't want to learn all the new music. So the concept was switched to standards. So again, 1959. He moves, Dexter Gordon moves to Europe and does this session. Now, Kenny Clark, Pierre Michelot, and Bud Powell had been doing, I guess it's in 1960, were doing a residency at the Blue Note Club in Paris, famous jazz club in Paris for about a year. They had been playing together, so they were kind of a solid unit already on their own. And Dexter Gordon had crossed paths with Bud Powell, obviously, early on, too. So it was a great fit. This record starts out with what you're hearing now, Scrapple from the Apple. In fact, there's only five songs on here. This is Scrapple from the Apple, a really upbeat, good, jammy piece. This was recorded, again, this is one of the few, this is recorded by Claude Emelin, a French producer. Obviously not a Van Gelder engineered record, since it was you know, in Paris and not in Jersey. There's Bud. This is Music Matters Jazz version. And the cover photo is also by Reed Miles. Interesting thing of note too, that I learned when I was re-listening this album. I've known this album for a long time. I've had it on CD forever, but so many of his albums and photographs of him, he had a cigarette in his hand. Then we get into a kind of a bluesy, jazzy number, Willow Weep For Me. That full throaty melody, that tenor. My favorite sax players are Lester Young, Ben Webster. I really like the bebop players. And Dexter's one that crosses over from that bebop period into the 50s and 60s jazz that we all know on Blue Note Records. But I say, go back and discover, you know, Bud Powell on piano, check out the Lester Young records, and especially Ben Webster, who's got that kind of throaty, reedy sound. I don't know how you really describe it, but I love that sound. Beautiful. Broadway. Track one. Side two. Kenny Clark. You know, Dexter Gordon was a big influence on Sonny Rollins and John Coltrane too. So he's that bridge a little older. Again, as I said, he was 40 years old in 1959, so that means when I saw him, he was probably in his mid-50s or so, mid to late 50s when I saw him. And again, still an amazing man. Interesting, in the photographer I work with went on a shoot in the south of France in the, I think, 1987 or so, 1987 or 1988, for the film Round Midnight that he starred in, a French film. Bernard Travier's film. Not a great film, great soundtrack. He plays almost like a version of himself, a jazz artist in Europe who has some issues with drugs, which he, like many others, had for a time in there. Worth seeing. This could pick up the soundtrack on Columbia. Obviously, it's a lot later period. But there's all these cameos in the film. Tony Williams, Herbie Hancock, Wayne Shorter, and just an incredible group, The Last Gasp. I think he died a year or two after that film was made. I think he died in 88 or 89. But just listen to these solos. Sultry, slow version of Stairway to the Stars, a great ballad played by Dexter Gordon. Very emotional. He learned this kind of phrasing from Lester Young. Again, that's, I think, why I got attracted. I got into Dexter Gordon in the 70s and then went backwards and got into Lester Young. Pork Pie Hat, great sax player, so someone else that you need to check out as well. And I'm going to end with Nine Tunisia, one of the all-time great ever in the history of jazz tunes. A lot of people know the Art Blakey version. This is co-written by Dizzy Gillespie. I have so many versions of this. But what a melody. Night in Tunisia. I probably have 10 versions of this song, maybe more. Is improvising on this in and out of the melody. I mean, it's classic jazz that we all know, but it just has a strength. This is a really good period. There's a series of records on Blue Note. I have several in my collection that that Dexter recorded for Blue Note while in Paris and while spending time in Europe and living in Europe. So again, this is from the Blue Note 4000 series. 4146, our man in Paris, Dexter Gordon. I want to thank Sherv and Dave and Rob for working on this series. There's a link below that showcases the ones that are available that we have that are still available right now. And just a fun series to showcase these great records. So check it out, Dexter Gordon, our man in Paris. Mazzy loves you, and I love this, right?